First, just tell me, did you always know that you wanted to be a chef?
I think when I was a kid, I was totally inspired by food in general and family, you know, events and holidays. And I guess we didn't find out until way later. There was a picture that I grew in kindergarten that was called, What Do You Want to Be When You Grow Up? And mine said baker. And there was a drawing that I actually did when I was six years old. And everybody was like, there's no way that this is real. But it talked about how I just loved bringing people together with cookies and bagels and things like that. And it was the cutest thing I've ever seen. But it kind of showed that, yeah, I was actually thinking of that in my mindset. But it really didn't come out until after college that I was completely serious about dedicating my life to food.
Yeah. And did you actually have a pretend cooking show instead of playing with dolls? I think I read that somewhere.
Oh, yeah. Oh, of course. I used to go and grab my melamine dishes and play out in the sand and, you know, mix mud in jars and pretend like I was doing cooking show. And also I learned my lesson once by cooking with mom's jalapeno peppers in the backyard when I was a kid after rubbing my eyes. So I'm sure you can imagine what happened after that. But, yeah, that was always a hobby.
Yeah. And now, of course, you went to culinary school, but you did learn a lot about cooking from your mom. Can you tell me about her and your experiences in the kitchen with her as a child?
Well, I actually wasn't really, I mean, I was allowed to watch, but I really wasn't allowed to touch unless it was like Christmas cookies or baking a cake or something. But as soon as I got old enough to actually cook, I used to play restaurant for my parents, and that was always fun. You do, you know, a chalkboard with one thing on the menu, which was always pasta. And then I would go, you know, and cook that for my parents. And that was really something I look back on where I thought, gosh, I really had it in me from a young age. And now it just is part of my life. So it's really inspiring to have a mom that loves to bring people together like that. And, you know, when you get older, you start to see her come out of you. Yeah. It's a little bit scary, but.
I understand you actually have a pretty good impression of your mom in the kitchen. Would you share that with us?
Well, I mean... Oh my gosh, she'll kill me if I do that. But I have to say that when we were growing up, she was, you know, always about, you know, Candice, you have to always eat real food, and real food is just so good for you. And I didn't really get what she meant until later on in life, where I started to study, you know, the Japanese diet, and I realized it was all about balance and moderation, and almost every single element to that diet that I grew up of was good for you. So that's kind of how I got foods with benefits into my diet and where, you know, I cook now. So,
well, wonderful. Thanks for talking to us, and I'll let you go on to get your hair and makeup done, I guess.
Thank you. That'd be great.
She looked great already, but yeah.
Thanks.